Hello students, let's start with a problem from the compressible fluid flow. The problem is based on shock wave. The problem states, air enters a normal shock at 26 kPa, 230 Kelvin and 815 meter per second. Calculate the stagnation pressure and the Mach number upstream of the shock, as well as pressure, temperature, velocity, Mach number and stagnation pressure downstream of the shock. Calculate the entropy change of the air across the normal shock wave. So let's start with the solution part. Firstly, we should know what are the assumptions. That is, air is an ideal gas with constant specific heat and flow through the nozzle is steady, one-dimensional and isentropic before the shock occurs. Properties of the gas, that is the gas constant of air, R is taken as 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Its specific heat ratio at room temperature, that is K, is 1.4, and Cp is equal to 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. The stagnation temperature and the pressure before the shock are given by T01 is equal to T1 plus V1 square upon 2 into Cp, that is 230 plus 815 square divided by 2, and the value for Cp was 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Now we get this as 560.5 K, that is 560.5 Kelvin. The pressure is P1 multiplied by T01 divided by T1 K upon K minus 1. Now this is, after substituting all the values, we get 26 multiplied by 560.5 K divided by 230 K raised to the power 1.4 divided by 1.4 minus 1, which is equal to 587.3 kilopascal. The velocity and the Mach number before the shock are determined from C1 is equal to under the root K multiplied by R multiplied by P1, which is 1.4 multiplied by 0.287 multiplied by 230, which is equal to 304 meters per second. Now the Mach number is MA1 is equal to V1 upon C1, which comes as 815 divided by 304, which is equal to 2.681. The fluid property after the shock are related to those before the shock through the functions. Mach number 2.681, we read MA2 is equal to 0.4972. P02 upon P1 is equal to 9.7330. P2 upon P1 is equal to 8.2208. And T2 upon T1 is equal to 2.3230. Then the stagnation pressure P02, static pressure P2 and the static temperature T2 are determined to be P02 is equal to 9.7330 P1, which is equal to 9.733 multiplied by 26, which is equal to 253.1 kilopascal. 8.2208 P1, which is 8.2208 multiplied by 26, equals to 213.7 kilopascal, while T2 is equal to 2.3230 multiplied by T1. This T1 is taken over here, so this becomes 2.3230 multiplied by 230 K, which is equal to 534.3 kelvins. The air velocity after the shock can be determined from V2 is equal to MA2 C2, where C2 is the speed of the sound at the exit condition of the shock, which is V2 is equal to MA2 C2, which becomes MA2 under the root K multiplied by R multiplied by T2. Now this is 0.4972 multiplied by under the root 1.4 multiplied by 0.287 multiplied by 534.3 kelvins, which is equal to 230.4 meter per second. Now the conversions are already shown to you in this particular problem. Thank you.